Coming up, student evaluations are here. We have the scoop on the latest changes. Also, housing construction is becoming a pain for some comments. Plus, we get the story of the youngest student currently enrolled at UTD. All this and more, starting right now on UTD TV News. Thanks for tuning in for UTD TV News. I'm Shinenye Wulu. We all know that course evaluations are important, but many are left wondering what happens to the results and how students can access them. UTD TV News reporter Jessica Higgins sits down with Assistant Provost Simon Kane to discuss changes to the evaluation system and students' ideas for improvement.
We used to do paper evaluations. Those paper evaluations were extremely costly. They weren't even processed here. We actually had to box the materials up and send them to Washington, the state of Washington.
The new universal evaluation system was designed in-house at UTD and saves the university at least $20,000 every year, in addition to providing much quicker results. The new online system allows students to evaluate professors and courses, all in less than a minute each. But students say that they still prefer to do the surveys during class time.
I still think if it's actually done in class, on paper, or even in class, if a professor says, you know, everyone take out your phones and do it on your phone, I think that would be better.
We're going to be encouraging even more so this term, online evaluations at the end of class while you're in class.
Results of the evaluations can be found online on Coursebook, where students can view the evaluations of sections taught by professors in previous semesters by changing the term to all terms, then typing in the name of a course or professor's name. By scrolling to the bottom of the page, they can see all the sections that a professor has taught and view the evaluation under the Evaluation tab. Not all students know about this option, and many turn to other sources for information.
Well, I think a lot of students actually don't know that, because, you know, at least my friends, none of them know that. I mean, we all use RateMyProfessor.com, and I usually use that. I didn't know, if I knew, I would have used the course evaluation on Coursebook.
RateMyProfessors.com is a third-party online interface that allows students to rate their professors based on specific elements and leave comments that others can read. Many students say they prefer this site to the UTD-sponsored evaluation system.
Rate My Professor, I think it's like the average scaling, and I think the comments are good.
Because you can write your comments on there, and it shows the comments. I think like you were mentioning, it doesn't show comments on Coursebook. So I think with the comments, it would be really helpful.
Putting the comments out for everybody to view would be a lot more helpful than just giving numbers. This is Rate My Professor. That's why it's so popular among. I talk to a lot of students, and they love that website as well.
The comments we consider private information, so we don't share that with everyone. But that information is shared with the, of course, it's the instructors receive that information. The schools see that information, and so do the administrators in central and in the university. All of that data is used in the things that you've mentioned. It's used in promotion and tenure, absolutely. It's used in justification for merit pay. We get a lot of emails from students frustrated because they're like, well, what is this information used for? You know, does it make any difference? And I can't give you specific examples. I can just tell you that it absolutely makes a difference. I've seen it make an impact.
Evaluations were posted December 5th and are accessible through December 19th at coursebook.utdallas.edu. Links are also emailed out to students during this period. This is Jessica Higgins reporting in Richardson for UTD TV News.
UTD is home to a diverse group of students, not just ethnicity or nationality, but age as well. Kwang Han has more.
Typically, traditional college students are in their early 20s, but Andrew Murrell is a student who is only 16 years old, who is the youngest student currently enrolled in UTD. Due to his passion for learning, he skipped third grade and was taking high school classes while he was in middle school, which allowed him to start his college career earlier than average people.
So by the time I got to eighth grade, I started doing some high school courses, taking Algebra 2, Health, and Speech. And that pretty much set me up for graduating early, which by the time I got to high school was pretty much a definite, as I knew I wanted to do that. So I skipped junior year. I was actually a junior for about 6 weeks. Along with that, I had to take a couple dual credit courses over the summer. And after that, I graduated, applied UTD, and here I am today.
Andrew is majoring in math and physics. He also hopes to get into medical school and become a neurosurgeon. He also mentioned how much he loves enjoying his classes at UTD and the environment of people dedicated to studying, which is something he loves doing. Kwang Han, reporting for UTD TV News.
With the addition of the new Edith O'Donnell Arts and Technology Building, people are questioning what will happen to the old ATEC building. According to Vice President of Administration, Dr. Calvin Jamison, the former ATEC building will soon house the Department of Physics. Currently, the department is scattered throughout different buildings on campus. This plan resulted from its cooperation between senior leadership and specific academic and administrative units working together in order to determine the appropriate decisions based on the university's needs throughout its growing population. There are two construction projects currently underway this year, the new residential hall and the new parking garage. However, the construction is being completed outside of the currently occupied residence halls and University Village apartments, causing frustration for many students. Sean Cragen brings more.
You know, 5 a.m., that's really early.
Sophomore Tucker Steven is annoyed by his unexpected alarm clock, the early morning construction crew outside the Southwest Residence Hall. Assistant Vice President of Student Affairs, Matthew Greaves, says the construction is part of the pains of a growing campus, and that he hopes it isn't too bothersome for students.
We've had concrete pours as early as 1 a.m. or 3 a.m., depending on the size of the concrete pours. We've usually notified the students well in advance that it's going to happen. Hopefully it hasn't been too much of a hindrance on the students, but we know this is a part of construction. Students have seen this over the last few years where we have the early morning pours, and we're almost finished. We have one more large pour left.
While the noise from construction may be an issue, some students feel it is worth it in order to expand the campus.
You know, some people may not be super happy by the construction, but it's a very necessary thing in order for UTD to expand and to become like a real university, because there's obviously big issues on parking and there's big issues on, you know, lack of housing everywhere. So it's good that they're building this huge resident hall, and then that all the amenities that come with it is definitely a plus, so it's not a bad thing.
Alternatively, some students believe the construction could be worked on around student schedules.
Honestly, if they just like did like, you know, construction during, say, like break or like over the summer and just intensified it during then instead of like peak hours of school, that'd be so much better.
While alternating the construction schedule may not be a feasible option, Grief assures students that everything is being done to accommodate complaints.
We've received a handful of complaints, but we've tried to work with those students and in some cases tried to relocate them on campus or just let them understand that soon the loud, loud noises will be over.
The construction is set to be finished July 2014, and the residence hall will be open for student living that fall. Reporting in Richardson, Sean Cragen, UTD TV News.
With the recent changes going on around the UTD campus, one has to wonder what's going to happen to the older buildings, such as the Art Barn. With the new $60 million ATEC building taking over for ATEC, EMAC, and arts majors, the old Art Barn has become less occupied, which leads us to the question, what's going to happen to the Art Barn?
They'd like to keep the building here for 2 years, and it will be a place for us to continue to have a visual arts gallery, as well as studios for graduate students to have places to work to do their own research and so forth.
While few classes are still being taken at the Art Barn, the building is primarily being used as a visual arts gallery. UTD's diverse student body is made up of not only students that live on campus, but also non-traditional students and commuters. There are many various activities offered on campus to suit many different interests. So what activities can UTD offer you? Here's Sophia Mayo reporting on the story.
The Student Union is a popular social spot for many students. From pool to ping pong to grabbing a quick bite, students can meet up, hang out, and relax in between classes. In addition to food and fun hangouts, the Student Organization Center can help connect students with different clubs and organizations ranging from academic to sports groups or volunteer to cultural associations. They even have a web application called OrgSync that allows students to join and communicate with the organizations they're involved in. Stop by the Student Union or visit their website to see how you can get involved.
On campus, I participate in the swing dance club, and I'm starting to get involved in the Japanese Student Association. I've been swing dancing off and on for a long time, so that was pretty cool when I found out that the UT Dallas has a swing dance club.
Health and wellness has proven to be a vital part of well-being. The activity center on campus offers much more than just a place to work out. They also have a climbing wall, swimming pool, tennis, basketball, racquetball, and disc golf course. In addition, they offer lifeguard and CPR training. You can follow them on Twitter at UTD Rec Sports, visit their website, or stop in for more information.
Most of the time, I have some free time here on campus. So what I like to do between classes is get a bite to eat at the buffet. I'm a big guy, and so quantity more than quality. And I also like to go to the gym, you know, get a workout when I can.
This is Sophia, reporting for UTD TV News.
This year, UTD had the chance to be a part of a Dallas-based event promoting technology throughout different means of art by hosting two sculptures in the new ATEC building. UTD TV News reporter Natalie Peña-Mares has more.
The pieces were commissioned by the Nasher Sculpture Center for the museum's 10th anniversary. The citywide exhibition is called Nasher Exchange and runs from October 19th to February 16th. It includes 10 works of art by 10 different artists in 10 different locations. UTD's ATEC building was chosen as one of those locations.
The piece that we have here is by Liz Larner, and she is a Los Angeles-based artist, and she's very interested in the relationship between technology and art, which makes her a perfect fit for the new ATEC building.
The X shape of the sculpture was described by Larner as continuing an investigation into the open form and the use of line to create volume. The piece has been developed over several years and was created with digital modeling technology.
Even though the piece looks like it is one piece of wood for each part of the X, it's not. It's several pieces that have been formed. And so she worked on this piece digitally before she actually created the work.
The wood version of the work was installed inside the ATEC building in mid-October. The steel version of the sculpture was installed in early November alongside the official opening of the building. With UTD TV, this is Natalie Peña-Mares.
Nailing a job interview isn't as easy as it looks. Career Programs Assistant Charmaine Ford gives us a few pointers on how to get prepared for an interview.
Interviewing can be scary and may be somewhat intimidating, but it's one of those things that you have to take head on. One of the most crucial things about interviewing is to make sure that you're prepared. Do you have your resume? What about your suit and tie? Half of the interviewing process is based on you, and the other half is based on the employer. So at least make sure that you're ready because your half counts. Remember, be on time, at least 10 to 15 minutes early. Be focused by asking questions at appropriate times. Be enthusiastic. Employers love to see people that are excited about their job. And of course, be yourself. No one can get the job but you. If you still feel unprepared, make sure you stop by the Career Center to schedule a mock interview so that you can get feedback about your interviewing style. I'm Career Program Assistant Charmaine Ford from the UT Dallas Career Center, and thanks for watching.
That's all the time we have for this newscast. For all the latest happenings and news about UTD, be sure to check out our website and Facebook page. Until next semester, have a great winter break.